Well, Galileo was fairly convincing in his argument that a ball rolling on a horizontal, friction-free surface, as smooth as polished silver, he said, that the ball would neither speed up nor slow down, and must therefore maintain a constant speed. What he would have liked would have been to do the experiment with a truly frictionless surface. Well, in fact, our linear air track gives a very good approximation to friction-free motion. The glider is supported on a cushion of air, which is forced through these tiny holes. So, when it moves along, no solid surfaces rub together. It's better even than a puck sliding over smooth ice. To measure the velocity at various points, we have some timers like this along the track. Each timer is connected to a light beam which passes between a pair of posts that hang down on either side of the track. The timing begins and ends every time the beam of light is broken. So, when a card like this is attached to a glider, as it moves past the timer, the first leading edge will cut the beam and the timing commences, and the next leading edge, which is positioned 10 centimeters along, cuts the beam again to stop the timing. In other words, the time measured is the time that the glider takes to travel a distance of 0.1 meters. And so for a measured time, t, the velocity is given by 0.1 over t meters per second, assuming that the velocity is constant over that short distance. So let's see what happens to the velocity along the whole length of the track. If the glider moves at constant velocity, each of the timers will show the same time. Point two two. Pretty good agreement to an accuracy of 1/100 of a second. Well, in case you think there's a slope which is compensating for friction, I'll repeat the experiment in the other direction and check for constant velocity again. Point 0.19, point 0.18, and point 0.19. So again, we get very good agreement. So this experiment confirms what Galileo thought, that an object moving horizontally with no resultant force on it will move at a constant velocity. But the story is not yet complete. Galileo has rightly separated motion into its horizontal and vertical components. But this was his difficulty. The concepts of horizontal and vertical are intimately tied up with the fact of standing on the surface of the Earth. So Galileo was unable to extend his understanding to the motion of the planets. What was needed was a synthesis to understand motion in any circumstances. The man who knitted these ideas together into a coherent theory was born in 1642, the year that Galileo died, and his name was Isaac Newton.